1961.
Thank you.
see one. With the capsule at the bottom of the Atlantic, no one can say for sure just what happened. In 1999, the capsule was raised by a volcano after 38 years on the ocean floor. Most experts now agree, Gus Grissom did not activate the hatch's emergency release, sinking the craft. After Liberty Bell, the Red program would continue with five more successful flights. Meanwhile, Grissom began work on America's next space program, Gemini.
Gemini was an important stepping stone. It's inconceivable that we could have developed the instant maturity to go directly from Mercury to the Apollo program and on to the moon. We had technologies and spacecraft systems. We had to learn to live and work with computers. We had to ride in the spacecraft. We had to do spacewalks. All of these came about.
In St. Louis, he went 12-hour days helping McDonnell engineers design a revolutionary spacecraft.
Some of them liked it and some of them didn't because it was very hard task and secret if they weren't doing it right. It was very hard to tell them that it wasn't right and need to be done. And so, he had a great input to the point, I guess, where some astronauts called Gemini.
The Gemini craft would carry two men into space with the ability to execute complex maneuvering and docking. By March of 1965, the first manned Gemini capsule sat atop its Titan booster. The man selected to pilot this first flight, Gus Grissom. With memories of Liberty Bell still fresh in his mind, he would name his craft Molly Brown. After the Broadway play at the time, the unsinkable Molly Brown, NASA was not amused and promptly ended the tradition of naming spacecraft. At Grissom's side for this first flight, astronaut John Young. Testing drew to a close. There was a spark inside the room.
space explorers.
Footsteps are still there. You walk in, as you say, walk in your footsteps behind them.